merci pour Dieu pour ça devant nous. Aujourd'hui c'est aujourd'hui aussi c'est le premier jour à Simel Ticha. Aujourd'hui nous faisons nous pour Dieu valeur et pour nous tous. Nous venons mon père Francis Bernie. Nous a tous de bout et nous a chanté. Nous n'y pouvons pas manger.
16, 1, 6. The prayer 1, 6. 16.
Celebrates and mark 44 arrived today to celebrate. Is it in church?
Yes. Yes.
And we can put our hands together for Jesus. As we come to thank him for the gifts he has given to us, we pray in a special way that he will continue to be with us, to protect and preserve us, especially in this hurricane season. We pray, we ask him in a special way that his presence will have a part in my life and in your life. Today, the Mother Church gathers together to listen to the word that gives us courage to journey as Christians. And that is why the apostles gathered to him this morning and said, Lord, increase our faith. Let us pray this mass, that our faith will be ignited, and our faith will never grow short. That our faith will always, at all times, remain steadfast as we put it into action. We pray for those who ask for our prayers in different ways, the mass intentions. We remember all who did this mass today. We pray for those who are sick, we pray for divine healing upon them. We pray also for those who are in serious devastation of hurricane here, and especially Florida, Southeast. We pray that the good Lord will continue to console them and help them to bounce back. You have a good opportunity to present your intentions in this mass, especially when we pray for our country, Dominica, for God's continued blessing. Good. All this we ask and hope to receive through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, we are sinners in need of God's mercy. In this moment, let us recognize that we are not worthy to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Let us tell him that we are sorry. I confess.
Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers.
Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting.
Amen.
Jesus, we love you.
Jesus.
Almighty ever living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Set injustice before me. Why do you look on where there is tyranny? Outrage and violence, this is all I can see. All is contention and discord flourishes. Then the Lord answered and said, write the vision down, inscribe it on tablets, to be easily read. Since this vision is for its own time only. Eager for its own fulfillment, it does not see. If it comes slowly, wait, for come it will without fail. See how he flags, he whose soul is not upright, but the upright man will live by his faithfulness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to the Lord.
Oh, that today you would listen. les aimons sur la vie. Frère, bienvenue. C'est pour ça que nous avons demandé qu'il est faux, car nous avons dit que nous avons mettre la mémoire sous tête. Parce que l'esprit bon Dieu va nous faire le bon Dieu. Au contraire, l'esprit bon Dieu va nous force, l'amour et le pouvoir contre les corps. Comme ça, on va besoin de monde camper et puis parler pour céder moi. On va besoin de monde pour moi et non plus qui est en prison pour parler. Au contraire, avec force, courage, bon Dieu va nous faire. C'est pour accepter souffrir avec nous pour bonne nouvelle là. Prends exemple sous parole la vérité, on était par loin, qu'il est fort dans confiance et puis dans l'amour de l'Union Jésus-Christ. Avec assistance Saint-Esprit, l'Union qu'elle nous, qu'elle est toute bonne parole nous est montrée, qu'on y travaille et à son contour. The words of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.
My dear friends in Christ, there are moments in our lives where we have so many questions about things, but we get little or no answer or corresponding answers. There are moments when it seems that all our efforts to get a precise balance switch over to reverse. The more we push, the more we get a pushback. You may have had a rough experience in your finances, in your marriage, and also in your relationship. It could even be physical, mental, or spiritual challenges that could lead to a depression that makes you defenseless. You know those moments in your life when you are not sure of the next line of action? Things are moving in a zigzag manner, up and down, that you could not make any decision. At one in time, you are in a state of confusion. My dear friends in Christ, today in our first reading, Habakkuk chapter 1, verse 2 to 3, and 22, verse 2 to 2 as well. Also, he was in an exact situation like these who have just narrated in the beginning. That is why he cried out to God. He cried out and said, "Lord, why have you failed to assist me?" He cried out for assistance, but no help seemed to be in view. At that point in time, one may ask, why was he unable to get help from God? Why? Brothers and sisters, the answer to the question is evident in God's reply in the first reading, which is our own concern this morning. Let us look at what God answered to this particular question of Habakkuk. But before we do that, we ought to know something about the faith that we are called to embrace as Christians. Many people spend most time in prayers, but very few experience or exercise the faith they have in course of their prayer. We can see that God, in responding to Habakkuk, first of all, dismisses the idea that he would not listen. Because many times we feel that God will not listen to us when we pray. And so we are not happy with God. We keep away from God, we keep away from God, from the activities, from what we ought to do. We are, you know, all because we think that God don't listen to us. So God, first of all, dismissed that, you know, as an assumption by stating that he would not disappoint. If you listen to the reading very well, he said, "I will not disappoint, and even if I delay, it's worth the waiting." Amen. Even if God delays, first of all, he will not disappoint. But even if he delays, we should wait. That is the point. We should wait. The waiting is very, very important. And it's in that waiting that we are called upon to exercise what? Faith. Amen? Amen. Exercise faith. He says, surely, it will surely come to pass. It will delay, but be sure that what you ask of him, and what he is about to do for you, will surely come to pass, because he does not tell lies. Amen. Amen. God does not deceive. He
said, my word must surely come to what? To fulfill me. No matter the situation, no matter what you encounter, all you need to do is to remain focused, to have that faith in him. And that is why he ended it all by saying that the just will live by faith. By faith. The just shall live by faith. God's response is a pointer that Habakkuk has faith issue or issues in his prayer. So many times we have faith issues in our prayers. We pray when we are not patient enough to wait for the answer. Amen. Here, one can understand that being just or righteous does not actually or automatically translate into faith. Being just or righteous, when you come to church on a daily basis, you do your best, you serve God with your whole heart, you keep to what is what ought to be. You are just, you are righteous. It does not automatically translate into faith. Amen. Amen. Because that will lead to that question that the particular lady asked me, I said, Father, I have been suffering, but God refused to answer me. What have I done? I go to church, I do this, I go to morning masses, I pay my tithes, I also take care of the needy. But why would God not answer my prayers? So our righteousness will not automatically translate into our little what? Faith. It will not. But it can lead to our faith. Amen. It can lead to our faith. Just like the case of Abraham. Or I'll say, in fact, your faith would show forth your righteousness. Do you get that point? Your faith will show forth in your righteousness or in those things you are doing. It is because you have faith, you go into those things, into those good lives, into those good qualities of life, and carry it out judiciously. Your faith should translate your righteousness, not the reverse. You get the point clearer. You remember the case of Abraham. Abraham's faith was credited to him as righteousness in Genesis chapter 15, verse 6. His faith was credited as righteousness. He has a faith. He has a faith. That is the point. This tells us that if we have faith in God, we are not supposed to complain. Amen. When you complain, it means you have no faith in God. And God will not listen. That is what people say, and they are confused. People get weary. Some, in fact, go into despair that God will not listen to them. God has strength to answer the prayer. All we need to do is to rely on Him, because every prayer we make, that answer comes before we finish our prayer. We read Isaiah chapter 65, verse 24. You will understand that fact. Therefore, all we need to do is to be patient. Wait on God, because He will surely act. He said, wait, I will surely act. It may be delays, but just wait. All we need to do is what? To wait on God. Tell the person by the side, wait on God. Do not dismay. Do not complain. Because He has His own way. My ways are not your ways. The way you want it to be done is not the same with God. Somebody may be asking for this vehicle. I want this good special SUV, SUV, whatever vehicle. SUV vehicle, a comfortable one, so that I can be comforted in life. I'll be comfortable in all my whatever, so that I can fly, I can be like every other person. I told you, said, no, it's not it is not time for you to have this. We will be struggling for that. God will say, no. Instead of me to give
give to these people, I will give you life. I will give you life. Because when I give you this vehicle, tomorrow you will see yourself in the ditch. And also, there on the ditch. And so he prefers to walk according to his will. So our faith should depend on the will of God, not on our righteousness. You get that point? Our faith should not depend on our righteousness, but it should depend on what? The will of God. Tell the person by your side, let your faith depend on the will of God. Because when your faith depends on the will of God, you will have patience. You will be patient with God. You will be patient in your situation. You will be patient in your trials, in your temptation. Just like what happened in Florida. A woman was being interviewed, and she said, I lost everything, but this hurricane taught me that I should not leave my God. You see, the devastation is so terrible that you can say, there is power that is more than my power. There is power that is something greater than my thoughts. So if this power can act this way, I should fear God. Amen. I should fear God. So this particular woman did not lose faith. Irrespective of all the devastation, she came to Florida, August, because this year, and September, she lost everything. My difference in Christ, sometimes God passes a message. He may tell you that, wait, I am coming in a better form for you. Do you believe that?
Yes.
Some that's us. That we are called to wait on him because he will surely act. And that is why we are called to befriend him who knows everything. Be a friend of God. He can do all things for us. Because those who wait on God shall renew their strength. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31. All we need to do is to have him as our friend. He can never disappoint us. He is there for you, no matter the situation.
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. All the privilege to carry. Everything to God in prayer.
Yourself when the situation is the other way around. So faith is is important in our lives as children of God. In the gospel reading today, Luke chapter 17, verse 5 to 10, we see the apostles also coming together, you know, to our Lord Jesus Christ to make a joint, you know, request. That is, they said to him, increase our faith. Increase our faith. Here, they acknowledge that they have faith, but they feel that what they have is not enough. Amen. And so they are asking him to increase our faith. So their request, our Lord Jesus Christ tells them, if you have faith, like the size of what? The mustard seed, they could tell a mulberry tree to relocate from this place to the sea, to the Caribbean Sea. And if you do what? It will come to pass. Amen.
Amen.
I want you to get a point there. Here our Lord Jesus Christ tries to tell them that what they need is quality-based faith, not quantity-based faith, but what? Quality-based faith. That is the problem of our society. That is the problem of Christians. We have faith, but we do not think that our faith is enough. We are asking Lord, increase our faith. So the apostles asked that question. And he said to them, if this your faith is as small as mustard seed, you could use it. Amen. Tell the person by your side, you could use that faith. That because you have a little faith, you could use that faith. All you need to do is do what? Use the faith. Tell the person by your side, put your faith into action. That is the message of today. We have faith. All we need to do is to do what? Use that faith. Use the faith. Use your faith. Use that little faith. Even if it's small, you can declare and if you do what? It will come to pass. You can say it and it will come to pass. You must understand what faith is. And then, the little you have, you can declare it. I did something. Two days ago on Saturday, and I said to God, I know that this rain will not distract this night vigil. I said, I know, because you are not a God who deceives. This rain, I am going to have my procession with you in the Blessed Sacrament. I will process from Savannah, from Newton to Savannah, and back to church. That was my declaration. And I did not declare it on my own. I declare it based on my faith, what? Foundation. And what happened? We finished the Holy Mass. In fact, the rain was, we finished the Holy Mass. And everywhere dried up. Phew. And the rain transferred from here to Casibus. Plus, here, heavy flood in there. And we began our procession till the next day. Not even a drop of rain. Can you please put your hands here for Jesus the Savior? Translate your faith into action. Declare it and it will do what? It will come to pass. This is what he said to us today, this Sunday. Even if that faith is as little as you can, as you think of, it can still work. Use it. The second message is that they need to put their faith into action, no matter how little. And St. Paul, in 1 Corinthians 13, verse 13, says, there are three things that last. One is, those three things are what? Faith, hope, and charity. We as Christians are called to search for this three wonderful virtues. It will help us in our journey in life, in our relationship with God. We need faith to worship God rightly. And that is why Habakkuk chapter 11, verse 6, tells us that it is impossible to do what? To please God without faith. It's impossible. So put your faith into action and don't be afraid. Tell the person by your side, do not be afraid. Because this is a child of the devil. The devil comes with fear. The devil comes with fear. And when fear replaces your faith, you begin to see yourself asking that question, why is God not listening to me? God is far from me. So, your faith must dry drive away
fear.
Our faith
must drive away fear.
But when you replace your faith with fear, you'll begin to see yourself going down the drain.
We pray in this holy mass that God will, in a special way, help us to put our faith into action. Because faith will not make things easy. Do you understand that?
Yes.
Faith will not make things easy. But faith would instead make it possible. Amen.
Amen.
Faith will make things possible, but will not make it easy. But it must be possible. God's answer to your prayer must be possible, because it's an impossible. I mean, it's a God of impossibility. Do you believe that? He's a God of impossibility. Those things you think will not be possible will be possible. So faith makes things possible. So we pray in a special way that He will help us in our faith journey as Christians, that we will never doubt but believe and remain steadfast in our belief. So who can deserve exceedingly? Is a man who believe and have faith in God. So let us pray in this holy mass that we will deserve God's blessings, who will deserve God's answer to our prayers. Let us ask Him so that when we do God's work, when we live a righteous life, we will not look for praises from man, from priest, from human being, but God. Just say that I have done what I ought to do. It's only when we depend, we have faith in man, we have faith in the things of this world, that we begin to look for what praises. When you have faith in God and you do your work, oh my God, you will say that I have done what I call to do. That is faith. May God especially help us as we study our faith and we continue to put it into action, that our faith will be translated into righteousness. May God bless His words in our hands through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before the credo, I want to read out a message from our government, the government of Dominica, on our National Day of Prayer.
Almighty ever-living God, I want us to stand in this. This is the prayer our government is saying. Almighty ever-living God, our nation comes before you today with a spirit of praise and thanksgiving for the many blessings bestowed on our country, Dominica. As we reflect on 44 years of independence, we must first give thanks for how you have led us in the past, and we look forward to the heights that you will take us to in the future as we rely on you. As we lift our voices in prayer and praise today, we acknowledge that in your word, in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 to 6 says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your paths." We give thanks to you, Lord, for guiding our leaders, professionals, and for us responding for the management of COVID-19 pandemic, from which we have been spared in this worst period. We pray for the continued health of our nation and protection from all other health threats to our people. It is your desire that we prosper and be in health, even as our soul prospers. So please, Lord, help us to make the adjustment to our lifestyle, that we can enjoy the blessings of health and prosperity. Be with those given the responsibility to care for the sick. May they serve with compassion. Help us to be good stewards of the resources you have provided to us, so that the vulnerable ones among us can be protected and provided for. As we reflect our theme for this year's independence, one Dominica, one people, one vision, we pray for unity of purpose, so that as our people, we can jointly engage in building Dominica as a resilient nation. We pray that our vision of health, safety, development, prosperity, and resilience can be realized as we work together for this common good. All this we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
That we profess our faith
in Amen. Our in your prayer place.
Vai o couloir pour faire toi, vai au cours de la terre.
bonté.
Jésus, écoutez-nous.
Pour la gouvernement et pour l'opposition. Et nous travaillons à l'unité pour l'aider Dominique. Nous t'appelons Dieu, Babodier.
Jésus, écoutez-nous.
Pour Dominique, pas faire si glorieux béni. Et si il béni, pas faire vitaler nous. Nous t'appelons Dieu, Babodier.
Jésus, écoutez-nous.
Pour tout le monde à l'office et tout le monde qui a placé manger à chalet, il y a une force là pour travailler bien. Je ne vais pas dire ma force.
Jésus, écoutez-nous.
Pour tout le teach à l'école, bénis-vous et il y a une patience pour faire travailler. Je ne vais pas dire ma force.
Jésus, écoutez-nous.
Pour toute famille, chaînons ensemble à la paix pour développer l'église. Nous t'appelons Dieu, Babou Dieu.
Jésus, écoutez-nous.
Pour le monde qui est malade, fais-nous prier et vaillons soulagement. Nous t'appelons Dieu, Babou Dieu.
Jésus, écoutez-nous.
Pour tout le monde qui est mort,
Jésus, écoutez-nous. In all our prayers, we ask you to accept them because we make them to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
by your commands, and through the sacred mysteries, which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying way by which you are pleased to redeem us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will pour out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Come on, put it on me, Jesus.
have peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as you are aware of the blessing of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity and courage with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We also offer each other a sign of peace as we wave to one another.
from the subvention numbers, number 200, 200, together we are Christ.
Thank you.
Immediately after Mass, we have a meeting for all parents with children in the Sunday school program. So immediately after Mass. Remember, I asked you last week to save the day, to the 5th, to the 13th, our novena, Our Lady of Fatima begins on the 5th, 6 p.m. daily. We are providing a bus, so we have no excuse, so that one supports our church. 6 p.m., I guess the bus will leave about 5:30. Diocesan appeal. Our target is $3,000. We are almost there. $2,333.09. So by the next full Sunday, we finish with that. I hope. Holy Spirit Chapel is having a prayer breakfast on the 30th. That is the Sunday just before the Independence. So they are asking us to support them. We plan on having our own prayer breakfast, but we have changed the plan. And I will tell you about that a little bit later. But in reference to prayer breakfast at the Holy Spirit Chapel, there are tickets, $20. Just like last time, you purchase a ticket and they will send off our breakfast for us. Because good the last time, I hope it can work this time. So just $20. If you want a ticket, you can check Shirley or you can check Gloria's sister or you can check myself. Just $20. You can book today and pay next week. On Monday at 5:30 p.m., there will be a meeting for all catechists at the Fatima Church. So catechists, please remember, meeting at 5:30 on Monday. Our treasure last week, $609.54. And the diocesan appeal, $710. Thank you so much for your generosity. Our team for next week, the commentator, Gary Ed, readers, Paul Vidal, and Kylie Thomas. Sanitation team, Julie Alexander and company. The family of the late Philippa Leta thanks all those who supported them during her illness and death and those who attended the funeral. A special thanks to the choir and to all others who assisted in any way. Thanks so much. And the funeral of Sisters and Uncles of Lord John will take place tomorrow, Monday, at the Fatima Parish Church. Buses will be available from 1:30. Viewing is at 2:30 and the funeral service at 3 p.m. Griffin, Edward, and Peter, these buses will be available. So let's want to support our sister. For our prayer in the Enchanted Garden event, scheduled for Sunday, 23rd October, at the Flower Show site. Remember? The Enchanted Garden event at the Flower Show site, 23rd of October. There's a meeting on Tuesday at 5:30 p.m. at the Flower Show site. All those who want to sell plants, food, and other items, please come. We want to make this event a grand one. We had a nice celebration 2 months ago, and so we want to make this one even grander. So please book that date, the 23rd of October. Quail in the Enchanted Garden. It takes all of us to make this a success. Any birthdays this week? I love the Quail birthdays.
May we stretch our hands upon our brothers and sisters. But to celebrate this day, pray to God with blessing. Our help is in the name of the Lord.
We in heaven and
the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God the Father, we come to thank you this special way for the gift of life, for the gift of another year, and then to the age of our dear brothers. glory. Thank you for being there for them. Thank you for protecting them. Thank you for giving them another opportunity to join in life. Lord, we ask you to continue to be with them. Bless them. Even as they celebrate this day with their joy and complete, grant them happiness. Grant them peace that comes from you, peace that the world cannot give. Continue to feed them with strength. And continue to feed them with your presence, that your presence will actually help them to accomplish their mission here on earth. And bless them also with good health to celebrate many more years ahead. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God bless and preserve you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
to tell us that we need, as devoted Christians, children who will serve God, our children who will be priests, who need this vocation, just like him. Please encourage your children. Encourage those who want to serve God. And you see who continue to grow. Just like I left my country, you will leave your country to come and minister to the Africans. Amen.
Amen.
Do it, and God will bless you. Amen.
Amen.
Our brother Whitmire will be having the little ones recruited to the altar to serve the Lord with their strength. So on Saturday, we'll be having a general meeting on the altar service. So if your child is interested, come, we will learn a lot. Our brother Whitmire will do that for us. Now that he is present, we make use of him. Amen. He is your God, he's our God.
What time, Father? What time?
Like 10 o'clock on Saturday. The Lord be with you.
And in your spirit.
The Almighty God bless and preserve you. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended when we go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Have a wonderful independent celebration today.
Thank you, Lord.
This live stream broadcast was sponsored by someone who is overseas. I guess he kind of like all mass very much, enjoy all mass. So he sponsored this live broadcast. So gentlemen, if you're listening, I hope you're listening. So thank you very much for being here. And God bless to you and your family. We would like to also ask all of your parishioners to help us, as we mentioned earlier, the Enchanted Garden, to go through the book, to read some points, to start reading points, to get our shots for windows. So we ask you for your support. So either give some donation in time or in cash, so we can start looking at that. Thank you very much. Our closing song is number 14:14.
Oh, this was National Day of Prayer Service at our Mother of Perpetual Help Chapel in Girardel, Eccleston. We thank you for joining us today. We hope you were blessed and do have a wonderful day.